So now let's talk about procrastination. This will be a series, perhaps 4 to 5 videos na gagawin ko. And I hope that after this, you will be able to strategize kung ano yung gagawin mo when dumarating na yung procrastination mode mo. So yeah, I took a class in Course Era entitled Learning How to Learn. And dun ko nakuha itong mga i-discuss ko for the next video. So, yung procrastination, tinawag nila dong zombie mode. So you have this unhappy feeling, then your brain tend to go to that relaxed na feeling. Parang hindi ka na nag-enjoy in studying your modules or what. Kaya ang tendency mo lalo ay mas pumunta sa more pleasant, yung wala masyadong stress, ganyan. So for the next video, I will discuss 4 components ng procrastination. Okay, so this is the first component ng ating procrastination series. So we need to know the cue. So perhaps you will observe this yourself, that there is some certain location, how you feel, kung anong time, and kung ano yung mga reactions mo bago ka mag-procrastinate. Perhaps meron kang tendency to procrastinate kapag sobrang dilim ng ilaw. Alamin nyo kung alin yung mga factors na nagkukos sa inyo na mag-procrastinate. For example, how you feel kapag ba gutom ka, ganyan. Or yung time, baka hapon, hindi ka ganun productive ng hapon, ganyan. Or yung mga reactions when it comes to that certain cues. So it is important for us to know kung ano yung mga yon para makapag-strategize tayo kung paano natin i-counteract yung mga cues na yon. So the second component dito sa ating procrastination series ay the routine. So ano nga ba yung ginagawa mo every time that you receive that cue? Remember, the first component is the cue. Ang pinaka-effective dito is to create a plan. Na kapag naramdaman mo na yon, anong gagawin mong susunod? So this is a very great example. If you're someone na yung phone mo, yung nagiging distraction mo, ayun yung cue. Na kapag meron nag-ting, kapag meron nag-ganon, dire-diretso na yan, na mag-i-scroll ka, the plan is to leave your phone elsewhere. And sanayin mo yung ganon, because the more na lagi mo siyang ginagawa, the more na magiging ganon yung response mo to that certain cue. Another way to really boost yourself to not to procrastinate is to have the third component is the reward. For example, kailangan, after nitong task na to, magre-reward ako sa sarili ko, maybe manonood ako ng isang episode ng isang series, yung mga ganyan. So that is a very effective way para mas matapos mo yung ginagawa mo. So reward yourself after a goal and a task. Also, set time. So kailangan after 5, tapos ko na itong task na ito. And after that, you can enjoy your reward. Habits are powerful because they create neurological cravings. So, gawin nyo lang habitual and habitual until you responded right to those cues na nagkakos ng ating procrastination. And lastly, we have the fourth component ng procrastination, which is the belief. Are you believing that your new system works? Are you believing that you can do it? Yung mga ganun ang mga question. Kasi minsan, we are discouraged kapag kunwari, we try to change our habits, pero merong isang time na hindi mo nagawa. So parang, wag ko na nga gawin kasi hindi naman gumagana para sa akin. The most important thing in this whole system is you believe you can do it. It is that you believe your new system works. Also, one way to overcome procrastination is to study with friends. Because when you are with the right companionship, it really helps kasi you can walk your journey together. So I hope this procrastination series helped you in your own walk. Let's fight procrastination all together. So this is a summary of what we have talked about sa aking past 5 videos. So procrastination is also known as the zombie mode. The zombie mode kung saan dahil masyado nang hindi maganda yung nararamdaman mo sa isang bagay, for example, answering your module, your tendency is to go to something na mas pleasant sa iyong pakiramdam. And yun, they have 4 components, the cue, the routine, the reward, and yung belief. The cue, alamin mo kung ano yung mga bagay na nagko-cause ng iyong procrastination. Next is yung the routine, how you respond to them. Kailangan mong gumawa ng plan tungkol doon. Yung reward, reward yourself para mas ganahan ka na mag-aral. Lastly, yung belief na dapat naniniwala ka na yung system mo na bago ay nag-work. So I hope this whole series helped you. So, see you!